Because I have got loads of people I've been with.
Yeah, this is what happens before the gig.
Because normally I can bring loads of stuff, but for house concerts I normally use, I've got little studio monitor speakers, which are not that much bigger than your ones there. I think we use, obviously I had these with me.
So what the hell, let's blow the windows out.
Let's rock it out, why not? Yes, it won't be quite as loud as it was last night. Oh, I sounded so good last night, man.
I thought your backing band were good last night.
Great.
Your backing band?
Yeah, it was him.
Yeah, you were great, but your band were terrible.
Oh, yes, there is Zoom.
Yeah, it should be.
Oh, T and W. Yeah. T is tally.
Oh, yes.
Same time. Smile for the camera.
It's a recorder.
Hi, the red light's on.
All right. And if you pause it, there's a red light on. And you can stay an answer.
No, I'm...
You know what.
Ladies and gentlemen, at great expense to Steve, I present Steve Lawson. Steve Lawson in the doorway. This time he's not begging.
At least I'm disguising it by playing music beforehand. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Chinchillas, and this little box that houses them, And when I push buttons, a little bit of food drop down, and they go, all right, we'll play now. And those of you who've seen this each other, they're fairly small and bases are fairly big. So they wear those sponge hands you see at sports games in order to be able to reach. So you've got little teacher and sponge hands playing meters in the box. And that's basically how it works. So if you're interested in investigating, just go into any music shop and say, do you have the tutorials with sponge hands? And they're like, bye, and they'll say, that's it. And won't look at you as though you're weird at all. An alarming number of my tunes are inspired by death. I was a golfer as a teenager.
Really?
And I just turned it into a sort of ambient weird thing.
That's
the kind of noise I would make. Feeling the pocket, like I'm here. That'll be Steve's ringtone. Yeah, it's very odd. And you have to pay more to get less of the tune.
Hmm.
Doesn't really work, does it?
It sounds like iTunes.
Overpriced and underpaid. Yes, so yeah, most of them are about death. One way or another. Mainly because the soundtracking part of this. And I suppose the function of a soundtrack in general is to put into, is to express the stuff that doesn't work in words. You kind of set the scene because someone's standing there going, it's meant to be really spooky right now, wouldn't really do it in most films. I'm sure that's the way Uli Harburst would set a scene working to make a film about Roy Orbison being wrapped in cling film. You have a man in the corner of the screen telling you what the mood was like. having a soundtrack, those of you who have read or are about to read Uli Harburst's novel, Roy Orbison and cling film. We'll be prepared for that to be a likely eventuality, but I tend not to do that, because that would make a very weird gig. Instead, I kind of try and put all that stuff that I don't understand into music, and grief being one of the hardest things, or bereavement of any kind, it's very difficult to go and put into words, and people normally end up talking bollocks about it when they try. Except vicars at funerals, because they say all the right things at the earth.
When they get their name
wrong. Yeah, when they go, it's such a shame Brian died. Why is Greg in a box? Yes.
I've never got the name of the family wrong.
Have you not? Yeah. Got the name of the actual deceased?
Yeah, I mixed up couples. So I had them, I remarried each side of the family to one another.
Nice.
Bob and Mary, but it was Bob and Richard. And
so, a gay wedding, you married?
It wasn't a wedding.
Okay, they're all dead.
So it was the family, something doesn't matter.
Anyway, so there are a number of my tunes that are about specific events and others that are just kind of more generally just miserable. But this one was inspired by the death of an author, a chap called Scott Peck, whose books I love and liked. And I happened to be playing bass at the point when I was reading it online. It's not a particularly good model for practicing an instrument, not one I talk about when I'm talking to college students about what they should be doing, just sit in front of a laptop reading the news. And I thought it was rather sad, because I quite like to admit him.
Was he famous in the 80s?
What, Scott Peck? Yeah. No, who was that?
Gregory Peck.
No, Templeton Peck, was it? That was his name, wasn't it? Which sounds like, for some reason, sounds like the name of a mouse. I mean, he sounds like something you'd call a cartoon mouse. Templeton Peck, it doesn't sound like a human being there. Maybe that's just me then. but anyway, yeah, so I'm where I'm tuned from. So it's called Scott Peck. I was like, I couldn't be bothered to be any more imaginative than that. Do you want to
thank you.
advantages.
But not for chicken.
I might tell that. So actually, the other seven, this, only this attack has its own story. Which involves Gareth getting sacked, it's great. Because this next tune was inspired by a film, which was of great significance and importance to me. From Dusk Till Dawn. Have you seen it? It's a very deep and meaningful movie film, up there with Robbie Gandhi and...
The Mission.
The Mission, Salvador. The basic plot is that Harvey Keitel is playing a lapsed Baptist minister who's kind of lost his faith and decided to run away to Mexico with his daughter. And they're kidnapped by George Clooney and Quentin Tarantino. It's very cool people to be kidnapped by, I guess. If you're going to be kidnapped and taken into Mexico as part of a sort of smuggling thing, heist, running away from a bank job, I don't know, something like that. And end up in a bar, which starts off as a strip club and ends up being full of vampires. I know that feeling, that's terrible. but yeah, so as the course of the events, the course of the film unfolds, they end up stuck in a back room with nothing but water and water pistols with which to attack these vampires. And so they need someone to bless the water so they can shoot vampires with it and kill them. And so George Clooney says to Harvey Keitel, says, ah, you're a minister, you can do it. He says, no, not anymore, I left that world behind. And George Clooney presents Harvey Keitel with a question, which I think is at the heart of the spiritual quest of all people of faith. He says to him, are you a faithless preacher, or are you a mean motherfucking servant of God? And Harvey Keitel says, I'm a mean servant of God. And the interesting thing is that the Scottish Episcopal Church adopted it as their swearing-in ceremony. Following the film, they were saying it was fine. And so now what you have to do is you have to stand before the council of bigwigs and say, I swear to be a mean motherfucking servant of God to help me Dumbledore. Is this not true, Gareth?
Oh, no.
Take it away, Reverend. So, yes. So, at Edinburgh, 2 years ago, I was telling the story, and each night Gareth was there because we were staying at his house on most of the nights. So I managed to rope him in as a visual aid. And then said, no, he is really an Episcopal priest. He was the swearing vicar. And people were like, yeah, sure. And I go, no, he really is. And they're like, okay. And then... You left the priesthood, and I think it might have been a connection, I don't know. But he's now a patron saint of people with Tourette's. So, yeah.
Do you have to be dead for a patron saint?
Not of people with Tourette's. They're less picky, apparently.
Just so long as they can shout at you.
Because when the Pope said you can't have one, they went, fuck off. You're all right. Yeah. Anyway, this is the tune inspired by that. It's called MMFSOG. Where are we going? Unpleasant. Grabbing to each other was all out for it, and the cords on going down. So, they can smell the crisps. Again, Mr. St. Geoffrey's bollocks. I could kill for a big time.
And he did.
Last night needed something a bit new. Right, I'll do one more and then we'll take a break.
Grendel.
Free bird, yes. Yeah, we'll just, I'll do something interesting and we'll see what happens. Hopefully interesting. That's the plan.
Thank you.
Completely switched on.